Good morning, bonjour, assalamu alaikum, merhaba. Thank you for that generous introduction. It's an honor for me to be before you. My task is rather simple. I'm here to welcome you to this august and timely gathering. As someone who has been involved in the formation of Carleton Center for the Study of Islam. For this reason, I'd like to say a few words about the center and also make a plea. So first, welcome to this gathering to the CCSI, Carleton Center for the Study of Islam, and Carleton University, your own institution as citizens. And I insist on that because citizens are the owner of wherever they are. So that great shift in modernity made citizens the master. That's why I don't understand when they call politicians VIP. You are the VIP, not they, because they are your servant just as I am your servant. You're all the employee of, or the public servant of, you as citizens. And I am personally humbled and proud to serve you as part of our great public education. Second, you may already know, but as a reminder, Carleton Center for the Study of Islam is still in infancy and has been around only a few years, and we have a long, but I hope joyous journey ahead of us. Those of us who were involved in imagining and planning for the center had a common understanding that we are creating a podium for conversation. And I stopped and I paused because I want you to think about that word. We are here to converse. A podium for conversation by anyone who is interested about the topics related to Islam and Muslims. The emphasis, again, is on conversation, which has taken a variety of forms. It has taken the form of offering classes. It has taken the form of offering formal gatherings, occasional classes, a few times classes, symposia, public lectures, conferences, and of course a workshop such as the one that is before you today. Some had already enjoyed the opening session ceremony last night, and I am sorry I was not there. I was teaching, so therefore I had already sent my regret. And others joined us today, but I think we will have a joyous day ahead of us, and I thank you for your participation and welcome you and hope you take an active part in this conversation. There is a good reason we thought about conversation, and I am sharing it with you rather than calling it a place for dialogue, a place for raising awareness, a place of enhancing one's education, a place one's enhancing one's professionalism, and so on and so forth. And the reasoning, at least for me, are as follows. The reasoning is as follows. Conversation captures not only the spirit of Islam, but also the spirit behind the creation of modern university, both. So allow me to parse that for a second. Insofar as Islam is concerned, I want to point out a few important notes. Number one, the verb to say, to tell, or to converse appear regularly in the lexicon of more than 6,200 verses of the Quran. Whether the conversation is about divine condition or the human condition or even the natural condition. And if you need more explicit reminder, those Muslims who pray, they start the major, very, very important small chapter of the Quran on the notion of oneness of God with qul, meaning say, talk, converse. Number two, the medium between humanity as God and God in Muslim tradition is nothing but the word, not a hierarchy of religious institution such as church or temple or anything. In fact, in Islam, the word is the sacred, and so forth. And the highest praise for a seeker of truth in Islam is alim, or the scientist, or the person who knows. Number three, in Muslim tradition, a scholarly meditation on God is called word, or conversation, kalam. And most important of all, the oneness of God means that God is everywhere and all places are the house of God. As stated explicitly in chapter 57:4, he is with you wherever you are. It's me who has started entering into conversation with God. And only then he appears himself to me. Now, as far as the modern or modernity and the modern human condition is concerned, the process of modernity is based on human logos, which again means speech, word, discourse, and reason. And the temple of the new creed of modernity has become universitas, the Latin root of the modern word university, which means the whole or the aggregate. That's what itself, the shortened version of universitas magistrorum et scholarium, community of masters and scholars, who are indeed engaged in conversation on any given subject of interest. The potential for conversation lies within the individual, and when it happens, it leads to mutual empowerment of all involved. Now, add the two together, the centrality of the word and discourse in both Islam and modern universities should encourage Muslims to feel at home in the modern universities where the public treasury helps the continuation of the conversation without any worries about group interest or particular point of view. That comes the notion of impartiality in modern universities, where all the conversation are open, all questions could be raised, all debates are welcomed and encouraged. Indeed, they perform their quality as Muslims every time a Muslim participates in the battle of ideas, which in the end empowers everyone. Now, how does one do it? It is by daring to become a player. And right at this moment, allow me to raise my hand and make such claim. In whatever condition one is, student, professional, parents, partners, lovers, citizens, you have to make up your mind. Do you want to be a player? Do you want to be a cheerleader? Do you want to be a spectator? Do you want to be a consumer or a subverter? Which one? It's up to you. Now, I hope we all aspire to become players. And to be a player, the most important condition is to be free inside. Free inside, as a result of which, when you get involved in conversation, maybe you get close to truth. And truth, as so eloquently, was popularized by Dr. Martin Luther King, truth shall set you free. And of course, as a reminder, it was not the word of Dr. Martin Luther King, that's why I said he popularized it, but it is in Bible, John 8:32. And you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. Logically, therefore, I would conclude that podium, any podium, such as Carleton Center for the Study of Islam, has the potential of making you free. provided you come forward and participate as a player in the agenda, in the arena. How? Either in your mind, by believing in it, so that empowers you to take part, or in your speech, by spreading the word that Carleton Center for the Study of Islam is simply a podium of conversation. And I hope some of you will help us by coming forward with your financial support, which would help us grow and become a more dynamic center for all of us, for the purpose of mutual empowerment. And of course, all form of participation, all form of being a player is welcome. And those of you who are interested, there are information provided on the web. Once again, welcome to Carleton University, to Carleton Center for the Study of Islam. Good luck in your participation in the conversation. And now I will turn it over to our wonderful director and also master of the ceremony for the day, Dr. Kelly. Thank you.